I am a solitary creature by nature. I have no children, no siblings, no parents. I did once have a husband.
If there is fate, who can say? But in the Grand Bazaar of Istanbul, I chose a memento.
I like it. Whatever it is, I'm sure it has an interesting story.
So, what would you wish for?
What is your heart's desire?
I do have a question. What does one do with three wishes?
You'll see.
Aloha. This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, coming to you live once again from beautiful Hawaii here on the island of Oahu, bringing you, guess you, the best movie reviews on the entire island of Oahu. And yes, this is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man. And yesterday, a whole week after it opened up, I went ahead and finally saw the Idris Elba, Tilda Swinton movie, directed and written, at least partially, by the great director George Miller. Yes, that George Miller from Mad Max, Fury Road, Thunderdome, The Road Warrior, and many, many other movies. In the new movie that came out called 3,000 Years of Longing. And without further ado, remember our rating scale, shock a thumbs up, it's good to see, I recommend it. Shock a thumbs down, it's junk, I don't recommend it. And for 3,000 Years of Longing, starring Tilda Swinton and Idris Elba, it is a shock a thumbs up. Man, this movie was so good. Let me just tell you, it is a strong shock a thumbs up. I saw the trailers and I was thinking, it's like, what's this movie going to be about? Because you watch those trailers, and it's like, well, it looks kind of weird. Apparently Idris Elba's this genie and, Tilda Swinton finds the lamp and gets these three wishes, but, doesn't want to take the risk of these three wishes because, wishes always go bad. And, I'm not going to go ahead and spoil it too much for you as far as what those wishes are. But, what we get is a light, hearted, warm, thorough comedy, romantic comedy, that turns out between Tilda Swinton and Idris Elba. Once she finds the lamp, well, even before that, and you see in the trailer, that Tilda Swinton's character is this professor, author, scholar, lecturing around the world. And right away, one of her things that she lectures about is, like the legends, the myths of ancient heroes, Greek, Roman, other cultures, like Zeus, Apollo, and compares those directly to, the mythos of today with the comic books, Thor, the Avengers, Superman, Batman, etc., with the DC universe, with Marvel and DC. And it's like, well, once we outgrow these myths and legends, what becomes of these old gods? When, where we are as today, we don't really have any use for them. As, they've been updated into, comic book, entertainment lore, etc. Not exactly, preaching, tales of morality, one could argue. And that's where she firmly lies. She's like, I'm a scholarly woman. I have no use for, the ideas of the past, of gods, etc. You know, I believe in science. And so right away we are firmly sat with it, with Tilda Swinton, with those beliefs. And during her travels in Istanbul, she finds Idris Elba, a genie trapped in a lamp, and opens it up. As you see in the trailers, he appears and automatically wishes to give her her three wishes. But as a scholar and a literary scholar at that, she knows of all the problems that wishes entail. And usually, you know, in these strange tales of myth and legend, anyone with wishes, you know, think the monkey's paw, you know, kind of a scenario, you know, things turn out very badly for the person making those wishes. And Idris Elba will confirm that, although no malevolence on him being, you know, the genie granting these wishes, you know, he must adhere to the wishes, you know, except for certain roles. You know, you can't wish for more wishes, can't wish to be immortal, blah blah blah, you know, because humans are meant to be mortal, blah, and only the djinn as himself, you know, can be immortal. But you know, and such like that, you know, is if it is out of your nature, then you cannot wish for it, he says. And let me just say that both Tilda Swinton and Idris Elba have, you know, they're both remarkable actors. You know, and I lean more towards Idris Elba, of course, you know, but he definitely does a fantastic job as this genie, quite outside of anything that we'd already seen, you know, be it Robin Williams with Aladdin or Will Smith with Aladdin, would be the most, I guess the most comparable as of late, with genies. Maybe even that genie on What We Do in the Shadows, if you've seen it. But he's more of an accountant. He's more, you know, Idris Elba's genie is a bit more of a traditional genie. But having a desire for stories as well, Tilda Swinton, before making her wishes, trying to decide on what to wish for, arguing with him that maybe she doesn't want to wish for anything, that she is completely content, you know, with her life as it stands, as you've seen from the trailers, you know, a single woman out with no other desires than her scholarly pursuits. We hear her tale as she tells it to the genie about, you know, that she was married once, but the marriage fell apart, and it is hinted at through the story that it is due to her lost child. Apparently, you know, a miscarriage, I believe, at some point during her marriage, you know, that kind of, you know, threw her into a deep depression, and as such, her husband turned to the wants of another woman. And the two divorced. Although amicable, you know, she really doesn't think of him anymore. Although she seemed happy at the time of her marriage, up until the death of her child. But never being able to move on from that point, her husband leaves her, apparently. And she holds him no ill will for that. And she sets out content to live her days out alone. But again, as a scholar, a storyteller in herself, and a scholar of other people's tales, she wants to know the djinn's tales, that how was he locked up for 3,000 years? You know, and he tells her the tale that, you know, that she was you know, that he was initially locked up years and years ago by King Solomon as he was attempting to woo his relative, another djinn. I should remember. I should remember this. This a famous starts with an N. I forget. But you know, King Solomon. Apparently, it's a classic tale. But he traps her, or traps him, in a brass bottle and throws it into the Red Sea, where it remained for 1,000 years before it washed up. And someone releases him, a slave of the Sultan, a woman, concubine of the Sultan, who wishes to become the love of the prince. And she does so, you know, because that's what she wished for, that it becomes so. She wishes for his child, and she becomes pregnant. Unfortunately, the king, being, you know, manipulated by his concubine, is told that the prince is plotting against him, has his own son, the prince, killed, has her killed as the heir to the throne, being, you know, the baby within her, you know, a threat to his power. So has her killed before she can make her third wish. And upon that third wish, Idris Elba would be freed. Unfortunately, you know, she is unable to make the wish before she is killed by the king's assassins. And thus, Idris Elba's, as the genie, is still stuck in the bottle for another 1,000 years until a new prince finds the bottle. Finds the bottle, but does not open it until later on, one of the prince's brother's concubines finds it and opens it. quite unexpectedly, what she wishes for is that, you know, as I guess she is afraid or angered by the genie's presence, she wishes him back into the bottle and trapped in the Red Sea where he came from. And so he's stuck to languish there for another few thousand years. Until, you know, it goes on and on like this. You hear these tales until he finds another person who opens the bottle, a woman, who he falls in love with, you know, and the two are happy until in a fit of rage, she wishes to forget all about him, and thus, you know, he is sealed within the bottle, forgotten about by the woman that he loved, until Tilda Swinton finds her, you know, finds the bottle to release him once again. And wooed by these tales of long, long ago love and lost, you know, Tilda Swinton's exterior, you know, persona kind of melts a little bit, and she realizes that, you know, maybe, you know, she's not as happy as she thinks she is, wishing herself to be as loved as the past wisher was. And thus begins a great romance with Idris Elba. And the two actually have some great chemistry in it. Tilda Swinton's kind of, as an actress, I think, she tends to take roles both as a man and a woman at times. Her gender, I'm not quite sure what she would classify as. I don't think she's you know, anywhere near like trans or, but she seems to be somewhat progressive anyways. But, you know, she plays a straight woman here in this movie, and, you know, you feel the connection between her and the genie Idris Elba. And the two have a great romance together. And essentially, that's what this movie entails. It is a movie of great romance, both talking of past... Sheba was Idris Elba's relative way back, that King Solomon had wooed away from the family of the djinn. And as he attempted to protect her, King Solomon entraps him, Idris Elba, in that bottle and begins his incarceration for 3,000 years and his longing to be free. And which meets up with Tilda Swinton eventually and her longing to be loved fully and, you know, love someone else, which turns out to be Idris Elba, the genie. I won't go into any more of it here, but it is a beautiful tale of fantasy and fiction, you know, with many, many moral, moral stories behind it. So it is a strong shock and thumbs up. And again, a very heartfelt, warming kind of romance movie that I think would be perfect for, you know, first dates, etc. And even longer relatives to watch, you know, not longer relatives, but I mean, you know, older people in relationships to watch as well. As it is kind of poignant, you know, and, you know, matters of the heart. That's about all I can say about it. Again, a strong shock of thumbs up. Much, much better. This is probably the best movie that I've seen for the last 3 weeks. So I highly recommend it. 3,000 Years of Longing. You can't go wrong with Idris Elba anyways. And Tilda Swinton really hits it out of the park with great chemistry with Idris Elba. And directed by George Miller, the story is on point. Nothing super fantastic, exciting, no big punches, but there are a few action scenes as he's telling the story, you know, Idris Elba's genie's telling the story of his life, through the Ottoman Empire and wars and stuff. So you do get little bits of action. So it has something for everybody in this. It is kind of an adult conversation. There is some nudity in this. So it might not be great for small children, although the morals and the fantasy storytelling of the past would work for children and keep them entertained. But again, you know, depending on your concerns, you know, again, just certain bits of nudity might be too much for your child to watch. All right. Again, it's Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, giving 3,000 Years of Longing a strong shock and thumbs up. The best movie so far this summer. Check it out, or I guess now this fall. Check it out when you can, however you can. I predict this is going to be a big hit on streaming when it goes. But being kind of a smaller, artsy film, it did not blow up the box office, although it deserves your attention. All right. Mahalo and aloha.